Welcome to GWeekly on GWTV. I'm Melinda Pearl, your host, and we are honored to have GW's own University Marshal, jill-kasle, with us today. Welcome to the show, Professor Kasle.
Thank you.
I know a lot of people are very excited to hear from you today. So, Professor Kasle, as University Marshal, you are the Chief Ceremonial Officer of the George Washington University. That's a pretty big role. What does that job entail, and what responsibilities go along with it?
My job involves working very closely with the Office of University Events to plan and design and implement all the big university ceremonies. The office does about 70, sometimes upwards of 70 events a year, and I work on just about half of those. So there are lots of things going on campus. The Office of University Events, as we say, they do the logistics and I do the content. Mm-hmm. They produce, I direct. My job really involves helping student speakers who are going to be part of an event get ready, for example, writing the script, drafting remarks for other participants, and then being the master of ceremonies at the event.
I see. Now, in addition to being University Marshal, you are a law professor here. What is it like to make that transition from Marshal to professor on a day-to-day basis?
It's incredibly difficult. It's so hard for me to be pulled in two directions at once. I'll be in an event meeting. I'll be in a meeting planning some university event, and I'll know it's time to leave to go to class, so I've got to shift my entire brain from the setting of University Marshal to the setting of professor. But my students really are my priority, so then I hate to leave class when I have to run out to run back to an event or a meeting or something like that. So the way I've tried to integrate it is to bring all my students to the events that I do so they can get the benefit of that experience that I'm having.
That must be great for them. It sounds like
I hope so.
They benefit a lot from having you as a professor.
I hope so.
Now the big question is, what is the purpose of the mace that you carry, the huge stick that everyone sees you with, or as you say, students call you the chick with the stick?
There you go. The Office of University Marshal was invented 500 years ago at Oxford University in England.
Wow.
But it was a time when Oxford University and the town of Oxford were more or less the same thing. Mm-hmm. So the University Marshal at Oxford University was the chief of police for the town of Oxford. So that chief of police carried the kinds of things that a chief of police might carry today, a baton or a nightstick to keep order and keep people from getting too unruly.
Right.
But the professors at Oxford in that day were all clergy. And clergy, typically, Christian clergy, will typically carry a staff or a stick of some sort, as a shepherd carries a crook to lead his flock. That recalls various Christian iconography. So the mace that I carry is descended really from two lines of thinking, one theological and one professional.
That's very interesting. Now, what is it about the working at the university level in both of your jobs that you enjoy the most?
Oh, I love working at GW. It is a university of vast resources. I've been here for 25 years. I was here before President Trachtenberg came on to be president. And even today, even after all these years, I am finding offices and people and things that the university does, things that the university produces that I never knew about. It's such fun to work here because there's always something new and something to learn.
Oh, absolutely. In all aspects of this university, the resources are great.
Yes.
Well, that's great. Well, thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.
Max Smith is here to give us his weekly sports update. Let's check it out. Max?
Thanks, Melinda. It took less than two full games for San Francisco slugger Barry Bonds to hit his first home run of the year. Bonds needs to hit a total of 22 or more home runs this year to pass Hank Aaron for most all time. But as baseball is just getting underway, several other sports are winding down. NCAA basketball finished early last week as the Florida Gators won their second consecutive men's basketball championship over Ohio State. On the women's side, Tennessee pushed past Rutgers to claim the crown. It was Pat Summitt's first championship since 1998 and her seventh overall. In pro sports, the NBA is just 2 weeks away from its playoffs, while the NHL begins its playoffs this week. To keep up with all of the Colonials action this week, be sure to check out gwsports.com 24/7 or tune in to the WRGW Sports Blog Monday to Friday 4 to 6 and Sunday 12 to 4. Back to you, Melinda.
And now for your GWeekly. The Cherry Tree Yearbook is now seeking applicants for a variety of paid editorial positions, including senior design editor, Greek life editor, student life editor, and lots more. If you think you've got what it takes to be an editor of GW's yearbook, please email or visit Marvin Center, room 407 for descriptions and applications.
Join Dr. Joanna Speer, director of the Security Policy Studies Program, for a discussion on post-conflict issues, disarmament, demobilization, and reintegration of forces on April 9 from 7:30 to 9 p.m. at the Lindner Family Commons at 1957 East Street.
Three seniors' honors acting theses will be presented on the main stage. Kara Shute in How Crazy and Zach Colonna and Jill Maybrook in John and Jen, a musical. Both performances will be held on April 11th from 7:30 to 10 p.m. Tickets are $7 for students and $9 for adults.
A student awards ceremony will be held as part of National Student Employment Week to recognize GW students who have made outstanding contributions to their employers this academic year. Awards will be presented to the GW Student Employee of the Year and the Stephen Joel Trachtenberg Cooperative Education Student of the Year. Don't miss this event on April 12 from 10 to 11:30 a.m. in the Marvin Center, room 302, with a reception to follow.
Join GW and AU students for Relay for Life, an overnight event bringing together those in the community who have been touched by cancer, on April 13th from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. at American University. There is a $10 registration fee.
Don't miss out on this year's Buzzing for Change, an annual fundraising event where students, faculty, and the community come together to raise money and awareness for children with cancer. Participants are encouraged to solicit sponsors and come to the event and buzz their head or cut their hair for Locks of Love, an organization which makes wigs for children with cancer. The event will be held on April 15 from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. in Cogan Plaza. In the event of rain, Buzzing for Change will take place at the Marvin Center Grand Ballroom. There is no cost.
Taking a look at next week, on Tuesday, April 10th, there will be a meeting to learn about finding international internships in the Marvin Center, room 302, from 5 to 6 p.m.
Stay tuned for GWTV's new Shows on the Loop, Melinda Robix, a made-for-TV workout class, and Upfront with Andrew Springer, who asks tough questions to get the right answers.
And that's about all we've got time for this week. Thank you so much for coming, Professor Kasle. It was wonderful having you on the show. Thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you next time. Have a great week.
My time.